part one. To like government advanced. Okay, so we have done the almost entire chapter except significant figures. Okay, so I'll be covering the significant figures now, and then we'll be moving to kinematics. All right. Which chapter is going on in school? Data measurement only. Okay. Till where they have done? What?
Start.
Just started. Okay. All of you write down. Significant figures. Alright, so we are talking about significant figures now. Alright, see the way we write the readings, okay, should also indicate how precise is your reading. For example, if I write 2.0 and if I write 2.000, in our mind there is this thing feed. That 2.000 is more accurate. Yes or no? It is accurate up to 3 decimal places. See, what I am saying, the difference between 2.0 and 2.000. Mathematically, there is no difference. Mathematically, there is no difference. But if you are mentioning this as a reading, that you measured this quantity, then there is a difference. What is the difference? You are sure that next 3 digits are 0. You are sure that these 2 digits are 0 and this is uncertain. But then still you write 0 here. But anyways, here you have 3 decimal places. More accurate or more precise reading. Forget about accuracy. I am not talking about the precision. Okay. So this is more precise. Okay. And this is less precise. Okay. So, you know, it should not happen that you will write the reading, let's say you have measured 2. You should not write in terms of words that your reading is 2 and in a bracket you write that it is more precise. It is precise up to 3 decimal places. Okay? And then you get a reading again 2, in the bracket you write it is precise up to 1 decimal place. Okay? So, to avoid writing in words about the precision, we write the number itself in a way that it represents its accuracy. Okay, take out this bag, I told you that. It will fit that. Put it there. It will touch that, no? And then it will fit out that. Okay, so what I was saying was, the way you should write the reading should indicate how precise your reading is. Alright? So there is a rule to write the reading to indicate the precision of the reading itself. Getting it? So it is, if you count the number of significant digits, it in a way gives you an indication of how precise your readings are. Okay? So please write down these rules, then we'll be taking up several examples. Okay, write down rule number one. Rule number one is all the non-zero digits are significant. All the non-zero digits are significant. Suppose you want to count how many significant digits are in the reading. Alright, then all the non-zero digits are significant, alright? So there is no ambiguity in terms of if there is a digit which is not zero, you have to count it as significant. Okay? No ambiguity. But there is ambiguity in terms of zero. How zero is placed, how it is placed, depending on that, you have to determine whether that zero is significant or not. Alright? So there are rules for the zeros. Write down the zeros between any two non-zero digits. The zeros between any two non-zero digits are significant.
If there are zeros between the two non-zero digits, those are significant. Understood? Okay. For example, if I say that 103, how many significant digits it has?
Three.
Till now, we know the whatever rules we know, we can apply and we can find out that it has three significant digits. Understood? Next rule, write down. A number, or let's say a whole number, you write a whole number having trailing zeros. A whole number having trailing zeros, trailing to right now, left to right, so trailing zeros to the whole numbers are not significant. Trailing zeros to a whole number are not significant. Okay, in the bracket please write down no decimal. You should not count after decimal places these zeros. These are also trailing. But it should be a whole number without decimal place. Then the trailing zeros are not significant. For example, 2300, how many significant figures?
Only two.
Okay, if you have 200300, how many?
Four.
Fine, understood? Okay, now write down next rule about the decimal places.
Okay,
is
the decimal place?
Write down, if there is a decimal place, then the trailing zeros are significant. If there is a decimal, then the trailing zeros are significant. Understood? If there is a number, then trailing zeros are significant. Now tell me, how many significant figures in 203.100?
Six.
Getting it? These are the trailing zeros, but they are after decimal. Understood? They in a way represent your accuracy or not? Sorry, do you in a way represent precision or not? It tells you that how precise it is. So you should count it as a significant figure. Understood? Now let me give you one more example. 0.001050. How many?
Five.
The answer is, it is only 5. It has only 5. Okay? All other zeros are insignificant. We are talking about decimal places, right? We just spoke about which zeros are significant if there is a decimal place. Getting it? So these zeros are insignificant. Alright? Now, what about this? Suppose if it is 1.00 this. Will these zeros be significant or not?
Yes.
Why?
No,
let's not talk about the logic. Talk about the rule. Between two non-zero numbers, between two non-zero digits, these two zeros are lying. So these two zeros are significant. Getting it? So you may tend to apply logic at times. Okay? This is the only part in physics where I request you to not to apply a lot of mathematical logic, because that may fail you at times. Okay? Strictly go by the rules, because there are a lot of exceptions. Okay? So what rule says? Between two non-zero digits, these zeros are significant. So that is why these two zeros you should count.
Now let me tell you, let me show you what are the exceptions I am talking about here. Now suppose you have a reading of, let's say, stop talking here. Suppose you have 2 kilometers. If you convert that into meters, how much it will be?
2000 meters.
Significant in both places?
One.
One only. Very good. Now suppose I convert, let's say, you have 2000 meters. Okay, if I have to convert 2000 meters in kilometers, what it will be? What it will be? 2 kilometers or 2.00 kilometers? It does make a difference. It is not mathematics. You are writing a reading where the way you write signifies what you want to write. Understood?
3.00.
It will be 2.00. Getting it? 2.000 kilometers. Now how many significant digits?
4.
Understood? Are you getting it? So these rules are not coherent. These rules are not coherent. Why? Because these are not mathematical rules. These are just set of rules which are formulated so that, you know, you can convey reasonably what is the precision of your measurement. Are you getting them? Getting it? Okay. So what will happen is that when you convert from higher unit to a lower unit, significant digits won't change. But if you convert from lower unit to a higher unit, significant digits may change. Okay? But that is absurd. It should not happen that way. Stop talking. It should not happen like that. Yes. I just told you not to talk. It should not happen, right? When you change the units, significant figures which signify how precise your readings are should not change. Just because you change the units, your precision increased. Okay? So there are such exceptions that are there. And hence, there is a different way of writing that should evolve. Okay? So this is not proper way of writing the reading. Okay, so there is a different way which is called scientific notation, scientific way of writing any reading. Okay, so please write down scientific notation. So scientific notation is written like this, A into 10 raised to the power B. Any reading you have to write like this, A into 10 raised to the power B. Okay, where A is a real number between 1 and 10. It should be greater than 1 and less than 10. Understood? It can be like 2.3. It can be 2.300, like that. Okay? Any doubts?
It can be equal to 1.
Yeah, it can be equal to 1. That's correct. It can be equal to 1. Okay? Between 1 and 10, inclusive of 1. How many numbers are there, total?
9.
There are infinite numbers. When I say number, what does it mean? Is 2.3 not a number? 1.22 is not a number? There are infinite numbers. Okay? So, you should write A like this, and B is an integer. It can be positive, negative, anything. B belongs to integer. Okay? So, when you write a reading like this, you should count the significant digits significant figures in the reading is equal to significant figures in A. Whatever the significant figure in A is the significant figure of that reading. Understood? Okay, now there will not be any ambiguity. Alright? Getting it? So if you measure something, you should write it like this. So when you convert the units, only 10 is of power will change. Understood what I am saying? If you convert, if you have a reading 2000 meter, it will be written as 2 into 10 power 3. Okay, if you have 2 kilometer, converting into 2000 meter, you should write as 2 into 10 power 3. Okay, but if you are actually calculating it to be 2.000 kilometer, what does it mean? You have calculated the measure, you have used an instrument which is accurate up to 3 decimal place. Okay, then you write here as 2.000. Fine, but mathematically 2.000, 2.02, all are same. But I am not talking about mathematical meaning of it. I am talking about how you can determine the meaning of accuracy or precision the way you write it. Okay? Fine. Now that we have learned how to write the readings, okay, what will happen is that, for example, when we did study of errors, okay, there will be some quantities which will be directly measuring. Okay, if you measure it directly, there will be errors related to least count and stuff. Okay, then what we did, we also understood what will happen if you combine the two errors. Because at times your formula, suppose force equal to mass and acceleration is there, your measurement of mass has error, measurement of acceleration has error, and you are trying to find force, which is a multiplication of these two. So we found out what will happen to error if you multiply two measured quantities which themselves have error. Understood what I am trying to say? Okay? So we learned that what will happen to error if two measured quantities are added. What will happen to error if two measured quantities are subtracted, multiplied or divided? What will happen to error if two measured quantities are added? What will happen? What will happen? That is a casual way of saying the absolute errors will get added. There are two kinds of errors. Okay? When you add two measured quantities, their absolute errors will get added up. When you subtract, what will happen? Their absolute errors will get added up. When you divide or multiply, what will happen? Their relative errors will get added. Okay? Fine? Now similarly, we should also know what will happen to the significant figures if we divide, multiply, add or subtract. Getting it? You have measured let's say two physical quantities and you want to add them. What will happen to significant figures? I should know that. You have to multiply it, divide it. So what will happen to significant figures? Okay? So there are rules related to that as well. Okay, please write down. See, this chapter, I can understand this chapter is not as interesting or as tricky as you may like to have it, but then this chapter is giving you free marks. Remember that. Okay, if you do not pay attention, you will lose marks where everybody else will get the marks. Lakhs and lakhs of kids will get these questions right from this chapter. Okay? So, again, focus on getting marks. This chapter is giving you free marks. Alright? A little bit of attention you have here, you will ensure that whatever question, be up to advanced level also comes, you will be able to solve it. Just little bit attention. Okay, so give respect to this chapter which is giving you free marks. Don't take it for granted. Otherwise, it will kick you where it matters the most.